Christ Tabernacle Easter Bunny. Along the way, they came across a man named Simon, who was from Cyrene, and the soldiers forced him to carry Jesus' cross. And they went out to a place called Golgotha, which means the place of the skull. The soldiers gave him wine mixed with bitter gall, but when he tasted it, he refused to drink it. After they had nailed him to the cross, the soldiers gave up for his clothes by throwing dice. Then they sat around and kept guard as he hung there. A sign was fastened above Jesus' head, announcing charge against him. It read, "This is Jesus, the King of the Jews." Two revolutionaries were crucified with him, one on the right and one on his left. The people passing by shouted abuse, shaking their heads in mockery. The leading priests, the teachers of religious law, and the others also mocked Jesus. He saved others, they scoffed, but he can't save himself. So is he the King of Israel, is he? Let him come down from the cross right now, and we will believe in him. He trusted God, so let God rescue him now. If he wants him, for he said, "I am the Son of God," even the revolutionaries who were crucified with him ridiculed him in the same way. At noon, darkness fell across the whole land. Until 3 o'clock, at about 3 o'clock, Jesus called out with a loud voice,
"Eli, Eli, lema sabachthani,"
which means, my God, I have no man." Some of the bystanders misunderstood and thought he was going for a prophet Elijah. One of them ran and filled his mug with sour wine, holding it up to him whenever he'd speak so he could drink. But the rest said, "Wait, let's see whether Elijah comes to save." Then Jesus shouted out again and released his spirit.
"Eli, Eli, lema sabachthani!"
Truly, he is the Son of God.
At the moment, the curtain in the sanctuary of the temple turned into a glass to Bob. But Jesus took care for him and watched him from a distance. Among them were Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of Joseph, and the mother of James and John, the sons of Zebedee. As evening approached, Joseph, a rich man from Arimathea who had become a follower of Jesus, went to Pilate and asked for Jesus. Joseph took the body and wrapped it in a long sheet of clean linen cloth. He placed it in his own new tomb, which had been carved out of the rock. Then he rolled aside the stone, crossed the entrance, and left. Both Mary Magdalene and the other Mary seeing the cross from the tomb and watching. The next day of the Sabbath, the leading priest and the Pharisees went to see Pilate. They told him, "Sir, remember what the desire once said while he was still alive? After 3 days, I will rise from the dead. So we request that you seal the tomb until the third day. This will prevent the disciples from coming and stealing his body, and then telling everyone he has been raised from the dead. If that happens, we'll be worse off than we were at first." Tell his wife, "Take guards and secure them best you can." So the soldiers sent the tomb and posted guards to protect it. Early on Sunday morning, as the new day was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to visit the tomb. Suddenly there was a great quake, for an angel of the Lord came down from heaven, brought aside the stone and sat on it. His face shone like lightning, and his clothing was white as snow. The guards shook with fear as they saw him, and they fell into a dead faint. The soldier spoke to the woman, "Don't be afraid. Come see where his body is lying, and now go quickly. And tell his disciples that he has been risen from the dead. He is going ahead of you to Galilee. You will see him there. Remember what I have told you." The women ran quickly from the tomb. They were frightened, but also filled with great joy. And they rushed to give the disciples the angel's message. As they went, Jesus met them, greeted them, ran to them, and grasped his hand.